Hello students, how are you all? I hope all you are fine and well. Welcome back once again to my environmental science class. Myself Shomiran sir. Today again I am back with your chapter number 25, Spicy Riddles part 3. I hope you have already watched the last two part of the video. In this part we will discuss the next two pages of the chapter along with some other information. And as usual at the end of the video there are some questions for self-assessment. You should go through the question and try to write the answer. But before that, you have to watch the video as well as you have to go through your books. And then you will try to write down the answer. So let's see. I am Kuttan. I live in Kerala. There is a garden of spices in the backyard of my house. There I see plants of Tejpatta, small and big cardamoms and black pepper goes. So Kuttan is a little boy and he lives in Kerala, and in his house there is a garden of spices. You know, Kerala is also called the spice garden of our country, and there are several places in Kerala where spices are grown. So like that, in Kuttan house also there is a garden which is full of spices. And which types of spices are grown over there? You can see some plants of Tejpatta. I hope you have seen that one. Yes, small and big cardamoms. Some small cardamoms and big cardamom trees are there. And the black pepper, which grows in his garden. Now, if it is asked which types of spices are grown in Kuttan's garden, I hope you can write down the names. Find out whether any spices are grown in your area. Write their names here. If any of the spices are grown in your area also, you can also write it down. Okay, in our state, actually very less number of spices are grown. But Tejpatta, it is very common. Do anyone have this Tejpatta tree in their house? If you have, you can collect some trees, leaves. Okay, as well as you can dry that leaves, and that leaves you can use in the cooking also. Why Kerala is called the spice garden of India? You know, Kerala is called the spice garden. So why it is called the spice garden? Kerala is called as the spice garden of India as it is known for producing great variety of spices. So you know, in Kerala, great varieties of spices are grown. That is why it is called the spice garden of India. Hot and humid climate with abundance of moist and loamy soil are some of the favorable conditions for the growth of the spices. So in Kerala there is hot and humid condition, where is a lot of moisture or water in the atmosphere and soil. So this type of climate, as well as it is having a very fertile loamy soil. So loamy soil is a type of soil. Okay, so hot and humid climate and loamy soil, these conditions make Kerala one of the favorable areas for the growth of the spices. In summer, the summer in Kerala is the best time for the cultivation of spices. So actually spices are grown in Kerala during the summer. It is the best time to grow spices. And you know, Kerala is located along the coastal region. Okay, it is having a hot and humid climate. Okay, that is why this region, there is a lot of spices are grown in this region. Next, bring some whole spices into the class. Write their names in the table. Close your eyes and try to recognize each spice by smelling or touching each one in turn. Put a tick mark in the front of one of you recognize. If you do not recognize any, put a cut marks. So what you can do, it is a type of activity. But now as the school is closed now due to this pandemic situation and online class is going on, so you can do this experiment at home. You should collect some spices from your mother and you will try to recognize the spices. Okay, you can close the eyes and touch it or smell it. By from smelling and by touching it, if you can recognize it, which spices it is, you write the name and put a tick mark. And if If you cannot understand which spices it is, you can put a cut mark. And after that, you just check it out what types of spice it is. So any 5 to 6 spices you can collect from your mother, okay, and you can do it at home. So here is a table, okay, in the different columns it is written number, smell, touch and the name of the spices. Some of the spices you can touch and understand, some of the spices you can smell it. If the fragrance is good, from that fragrance you can understand which spices it is and you can write the name. So one sample I have given as a paper, okay, on this slide. So from there you can get an idea. Suppose strong smell and uneven surface. So name of the spices is cardamom. Strong and smooth, it is chili. If you feel or touch the chili, you can find it is a strong smell it is having, as well as it is smooth, the body is very smooth. Light and uneven surface, if it is very light smell and the surface, if you touch it, you can find an uneven surface, you can find it is ginger. Strong and smooth, you can, if it is strong and smooth, it can be the turmeric. Okay, strong and uneven surface, it can be the garlic. So in this way you can find out. So there are some examples of it. You can collect some other spices and you can write it by your own. Next, let us do another activity. Let us try making a spicy potato chaat. I hope many of you are fond of mini potato chaats. Okay, you have also bought from different types of shops and you have eaten. Okay, we are also enjoying these types of spicy potato chaat. Okay, so what we can do at home? For this, you need some boiled potatoes, enough for everyone in your class. If you want to make it for your classmate, you should just boil some potato, and if you want to make it for your family member, you also can do it. Salt, red chili powder, mango powder, that is amchur, lemon, according to the taste. So in that potatoes, boiled potatoes, you can cut it into some small pieces and you can add these types of salt, red chili powder, mango powder, amchur, lemon, according to the taste. Okay, another thing, you know, do you know what is a garam masala? A powder or mixture of several spices such as cardamom, then big or small cloves, cumin seeds, cinnamon, black pepper, dry ginger. These are mixed and we are making one masala, which is also called the garam masala. And many of, if you add garam masala into any dishes, it will give a good fragrance and good taste. You can ask your parents also how to prepare the garam masala. I hope they can also help you for preparing garam masala. Now some other things which are required for the potato chaat: roasted cumin seed, jeera, black salt, garam masala if possible. If you want to add some more spices in your potato chaat, you can also add roasted cumin seed, okay, black salt. You can add garam masala also if possible. If it is available with you, it will make the your potato chaat more tasty. And some fresh coriander leaves, okay, dhaniya patta or coriander leaves, you can also mix it. And nowadays in the winter season, it is easily available, coriander leaves, so you can also add it. So in this way you can try to make one potato chaat at your home, okay, and you can serve it to your family members, okay, and ask them the feedback how it is, okay. So you can take the help of your parents, your mother, okay, and you can prepare one potato chaat and give me the feedback how you have made it, what, how does it taste, okay. So according to the taste, you can add different spices in the potato chaat and you can make it more delicious. Okay, I hope you will enjoy the making of potato chaat. Now there are some important question. Okay, important question part 3. Sauf or amiseeds, they are having a strong smell. It is usually added to food as a powder, refresh the mouth, all of the above. So which things are related with this sauf? Okay, there are 4 options. Go through these 4 options, and among these 4 options, which one you think correct, you can write it down in your copy. So first of all, you have to copy the question, then you have to put a tick mark. mark in the correct option. The next question. In Kuttan's garden, dash grow. So you have heard about the little boy Kuttan. He is having a small garden in the backyard of his house. So some spices are grown over there. You have already read in the chapter. So which spices are grown? Among which of these following spices? Cumin seeds, small and big cardamom, red chilies, or coriander leaves. Okay, so you choose the correct option and you write it down. Next, dash is used to make potato chat. Just now we have discussed about potato chat and some of the ingredients and some spices which are used for this potato chat. So is it salt? Is it amchur powder or mango powder? Is it red chili powder? Or all of the above things are required for the chat. So which one you think is the correct? You just write it down. Number 4. Cumin seeds are used in both sweet and salt dish. Is this statement true? You have heard about the cumin seeds. So they are used in sweet dish and the salt dish. So is the statement true or false? Write your answer in the blank. Next, 5th question. Clove make our food tasty. It is a small typing mistake. It will be not poor. It is our food tasty. Okay. So is it true or false? So you can write the answer. How? When we are putting the cloves in our food, is it become tasty or not? Next, number 6. Dash is chocolate color and smell strongly. So which spices is chocolate in color and it also smell strongly? I hope you have understood about the spice. We have discussed it in part 2. So one question I have given from your previous part. So I hope you can, which is in chocolate in color and it is also having a strong smell. Okay, guess it and write it down. Next, number 7 question. Which spice, when added to curd or jaljeera, makes tasty? So, which spice you know that when we put in curd while making some raita or some other dishes with curd, if you put it in the curd or any jaljeera sarbat, okay, it makes it tasty. So, can you find the name? I hope you can guess it about which spices I am telling. So, what you have understood, just write down the answer. So already we have discussed the third part, okay, along with the question. One page about the potato chart is still left. We will discuss it on the part 4 of our video. And along with this, I will also give you some question to do it. But before that, you have to complete the questions of this part. And you have to read the chapter properly. And for the spices, I have told, for extra information about the spices, you can ask your parents for the help, your mother in your kitchen. I hope you have seen many of the spices. You can ask your mother about the spices, what are the use, and this activity which I have given. Okay, to write the name of the spice by smelling or touching, as well as the potato chart, you can try it at your home. So thank you, students. Thank you, everyone, and have a nice day ahead.